Hi, I'm Roland at Intinor, and in this video I'm going to show you how we can do bonding with KA-SAT and 3G, 4G together. Because using only KA satellite internet is risky. It's an internet connection and that can fail. There are no guarantees. Then combining 3G and 4G together with KA-SAT makes the transmission much more robust. We can also reduce the costs by doing this, and we can also increase the quality of the videos. So it's really worth thinking about. So let's have a look at the demo setup. Here we have the Intinor Direct Link 400 rack encoder. And here is a modem device we have developed. We call it Heimdall. It has 4 or 8 3G, 4G SIM cards in a rack unit, and it's connected to the rack encoder. We have 3G, 4G antennas here that gives us very good 3G, 4G connectivity. We have the KA-SAT modem. On the wall, we have a dish pointed to the satellite. And then those together are sending over the internet to the router over here. And we can see on the TV, we can see the output from the router. So let's have a look in the web interface on the status page. We have IP1 connected to the Viasat modem. It's has 11 dB signal strength, 5 megasymbol per second, because today is a bit cloudy, and of course we don't know if the weather turns worse, we will have a bad KA-SAT connection. So it's very good to have those 3G, 4G networks here. And we always recommend using two different operators, network operators. So in this case we have Tele2 and Telia as network operators. So then we can also have a look at, there's a new feature called data cost. So in this case, we can tell the protocol, the Bifrost protocol, which internet connection is more costly. And if we have booked data on the KA-SAT, we have booked maybe 6 megabit, because we want to use at least 6 megabit. And then the cost of using KA-SAT is free after we have booked it. We have already paid for it. So we put KA-SAT on free, and we put the other 3G, 4G modems on medium. That means that it will use as much as possible of the KA-SAT, and it will fall over to use the 3G, 4G if needed, and also to increase the quality. We go to the active settings, and we see that I have set an encoding mode that is 7 megabit. I could set 10 megabit if I want a higher quality, and then the 3G, 4G modems will have to send more data. I activate the Bifrost stream to the router over here. And I also adjust the Bifrost settings in the web interface. So redundancy is very good to have balanced when you're combining different networks. Burst loss resilience I also set to balanced. If low latency is important, you can set it to low latency. Audio redundancy is very good. If one very important connection fails, then the audio is always sent over at least 2 connections, so there will be no interruption in the audio. And I use a custom end-to-end delay. I add 0.5 seconds to the Bifrost latency depending on the encoding mode and the other settings, because of the KA-SAT will need another network latency. So if I now save and activate those settings, we can go and see how the modems interact with each other and how we get video on the TV there. So now we can see that those are the 3G, 4G modems. They are actually using the same bitrate, all of them, so they are in the same line. The red line is the KA-SAT, and because KA-SAT is working, Bifrost is increasing the bitrate used over KA-SAT. We can also see that we use a lot of redundancy here, and that is when we start to initiate the system. So after a while, this will be, we will use less and less of the 3G, 4G capacity, because we set this cost to medium and we set the KA to high. And now the KASAT is increasing here. We are using more and more KASAT, and we are also using less redundancy. So after a while, we will use very little of the 3G, 4G modems. But when the KA comes up to the ceiling of that is configured as 6 megabit, it will stop increasing, because we have only booked 6 megabit. So in this case, we have KA on 6 megabit, and we have the other 3G, 4G modems adding some data to this and redundancy. And we can send the 6.5 megabit video, 7 megabit total video plus audio, and we have a very good signal through. So in this case, we are not using so much 3G, 4G data, but we are still getting a very good and very robust signal through. So what would be the worst case that could happen now? That is that this satellite modem that carries most of the data is suddenly lose the connection. So I will simulate this by disconnecting the network cable here. And we can see now in the web interface that the KA capacity dropped to almost nothing or nothing. We had a small video interruption in the stream, but no audio interruption.
Say you do. Härifrån.
Han lirar ju nu.
And very quick, the 3G, 4G modems took over and used more data. And also we add a lot more redundancy for a while, because now the system is initiating again. And we also dropped to a lower bitrate in video and audio. So after a few seconds now, we are on 6.5 megabit again. And now we are using only 3G, 4G. So I can reconnect the satellite modem. And that should come back. And I want to show you also the other scenario. This is when you have booked data on the KSAT. So KSAT is kind of free to use. But if you want to use as little KA as possible, you can go to the data cost in the web interface, and you can set KASAT to high cost. Then save and activate. And this will not cause any interruption in the stream if we just change the data cost. And if we now go back into the overview and see how much data is used, so we can see that now 6.5 megabit is sent over 3G, 4G. So all the 3G, 4G modems are working, but the KASAT is not using any data because it's not needed. Now, if we have a very bad 3G, 4G connectivity, then the KASAT will increase here and use more. But we are quite sure that we can get 6.5 megabit of video as we wanted, and that there will be, in worst case, very small interruptions. So this is a way to save money and to increase quality and redundancy. So that's what I wanted to show you. Thank you very much for watching.